day.
Oh. And this is what I came up with. Live streamers, TikTokers, YouTubers, we've seen a huge rise in PNGTubers lately, some of them making content that goes completely viral. Now, PNGTuber is basically a subcategory of VTubers, which is virtual YouTubers, virtual content creators. Now, the concept of VTubers is nothing new. People will use it if they don't want to show their face or for creative purposes. So a PNGTuber is a VTuber, but that uses still images. Now, VTubers in general, but also PNGTubers, will have different levels of complexity. Some of them will be using software that actually tracks their faces so that they can recreate their facial expressions. And one of the simplest forms is to have an image that basically either switches or reacts to audio. This is what I want to do today. So after seeing more and more of them, I started wondering, how are they doing this? What software are they using? So I used this magical technique called Googling it. And one of the simplest tools that I found is called Vidotube. It's like someone is misspelling video. And this claims to have an easy setup, add motion to your avatar, switch between avatar states, GIF and animated PNG support. Let's download it. Brings us here and then we click download now. Keep in mind that this is completely free, so you don't have to pay. You can just click no thanks. Just take me to the downloads. Boom. And you can download it for your system. See, bottom left, it is downloading right now. When it's done downloading, it's gonna be this zip file right there. I'm gonna right click and extract it. Let's extract to a folder. In the folder should be VTube video, VTube mini right there. And then let's double click on the exe file, just executable file, the software. Okay, nothing is happening. Oh, there you go. It was made with Unity. Wow. Okay, let's maximize this. And as you can see, if you put your mouse away, it's going to be a green screen because this is what you're going to use basically to import it as a window capture, I'm guessing, in OBS. Right there on the left, you can see you have your microphone device. If you click on it, you can pick your microphone and it has a threshold, right? So if there's like background noise that's going like, it's not gonna pick it up, right? Until you go above the threshold. Now it's gonna know to speak. It's so weird seeing that thing react to my voice like that, but I love it. So this is basically the default, the example of avatar they have. If you hover over certain things, it will tell you what they are. So this is the closed mouth image, that one. Open mouth image, and then there are some transitions, closed mouth blinking, and there's also open mouth blinking to give it more realism. On top of those specific images, you can also add some effects like shake, which is what you're seeing right now. When I'm talking, it's shaking, and I click once, it changes color, so it's gonna shake even more. And now when I speak, it's gonna bounce. I'm being especially loud just to show this. Let me turn that down. I don't need to be that loud. So you can click on those in order to add the effect. So now the static image is also slowly moving. So it's vibing. Now it's shaking. Shaking more. Bouncy. Excited. Bouncing left and right, basically. Nervous, bouncing left and right. Vigorously. And then static. So you can do that for everything. The third option is the mouth transition. It's basically the state in between not speaking and speaking. So it's realistic when you just open your mouth, you know? I know I'm saying realistic. There's nothing realistic about any of that. On the bottom left, you can also see background color. So here we have greens if you want to use the green screen. I don't know if you have transparency. There is transparency. This is transparency. So I'm guessing if you add this to OBS and you click allow transparency in the window capture or game capture source, it will just be transparent. So you don't need to do any chroma keying. Then we have open and then save. Let's see if they include anything else. So in that zip folder, you can find avatar examples. Oh, yes. There are. We have fish, Ogato, Pop, Steamy Paw, Tube, Viado. Viado, that's how you pronounce it? Fish? Oh. So when I tell you anything can be a VTuber, anything can be a PNG tuber. It's the picture of a fish. Except this one reacts, so it's actually an advanced. Let me make it shake. Let me make it vibe when I talk. Let me make it shake when I talk. Nice. Let's see the other ones. A. O. A. O. Hey, and of course, the reason why you're watching this video is to be the PopCat. What the? Oh, okay. Where's the VIA? Oh. And of course, it accepts animated GIFs. So every single state can be an animated GIF, right? So I can have a GIF of this one with the mouth open, one with the mouth closed. All right, let's go back to this one. It's the cutest. There's also multiple states that you can set hotkeys for, I believe. If I click on create state, I believe I can modify this, and this is basically the second state, right? I'm gonna modify it so that it's very visible. And if I click back to the first state, then it's different. Okay, I believe you can also change, maybe if you change the images, it's gonna be different. If I click on one of the images, I have the option to remove them or to change them. I'm gonna change one just to test. It's gonna mess it up. Put a random image. So this is a different state. So if I click back here, it's gonna be the normal one, right? And then boom, different state. I don't know if you're doing multiple things or you want to switch it up when you're excited. I know that you can set up hotkeys. If I click here, and I click on G, for example, it will automatically assign the hotkey to that state that I'm on right now. So if I go back to this one and I put H, I can switch between G and H. G and H. Now, usually people will go ahead and make a lot of cute things. You will see a lot of cats and anime girls and all that stuff. Now, this is the part where you would create a cute character, like an anime girl or a cat or whatever animal you want, or you would pay an artist to make those images for you. And there's a lot of them. Just check on Twitter, a lot of them. Watch out for bots though. But when I was thinking about making this video, I had a little idea, and let me show you what it is. Now, of course, I could take a couple of pictures of myself, but it would ruin the idea of people using it to not show themselves. Right? So it made me think of a situation where one face basically switched up and I could use multiple images of that person's face. And this is what I came up with. Oh my god. This is... obviously, I'm not actually gonna use this. I'm more of a on-camera person. But if you're doing your VTuber, think about copyright, okay? I'm not legally responsible if you go ahead and get yourself a copyright strike or something like that. But basically, we want to cut out our boy, Mr. Baggins. I'm using Photoshop. I'm gonna click on the magic wand tool. And I'm gonna click select subject and see what Photoshop does with it. Oh my god, Photoshop is so good. And then click a mask, create a mask. Basically, it's like that now. Since it doesn't change that much between the two, I can hold Alt, drag down the mask to create the same mask on the second one. And let's see the third one. We might actually want to select that one to change the mask. Click select subject with the magic wand tool selected. And let's hope for the best. And that is the best. There we go. Now we have our three. Our three states. I'm just gonna crop this and export each image as a PNG, transparent PNG, and then we're good to go. All right, all the images are saved. Let's go back to here, and we're just gonna replace some images. So this is the closed mouth image. I can't. And then we need an open mouth image. We're gonna click change image. Open mouth is that one. We're gonna delete the other ones. And for closed mouth blinking image, I'm gonna add the one in between because I just realized that I said something wrong. I did everything wrong, actually. Wait, this is not supposed to be the closed mouth image. I want him to be smiling on the first one. Sorry, let me switch that. I mislabeled them. So now for closed mouth blinking image, I'm gonna add the transition image. So hopefully if I don't talk, eventually he will do the face. So the part that I got wrong is this. It's not an image that's gonna be a transition in between. It's just the animation in between the normal state and the open mouth state. So every time I speak, you see a jump, that's the animation. Or it doesn't jump now that I turned it off, right? So you can make it jump every time you speak. I think it adds a little more depth to it. So that's pretty cool. I like that. So there it is. This is my, this is my PNG tuber. And don't you dare tell me this is not the cutest PNG tuber. Let's add it to OBS. So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna click on the plus at the bottom here, and I'm gonna go find game capture. Hopefully that's the one with transparency. Yes, it is, okay. And here I'm gonna find capture specific window, cause that's what we want. And that specific window is going to be Viadotube Mini. I still struggle to say it. And here we are. Now you want to make sure that you go down here and you click allow transparency. Boom, click OK, and you're pretty much set. I don't see what it looks like right now. So hey, I'm getting level. I mean, I can't. And of course, you can scale it down by dragging the corners in. Oh my god. Oh my god. Also, you can make it move in between the states and stuff like that. So, yeah. Oh, it's even better when it's shaking. I can't stop playing with this. But basically, this is the tutorial. You can go and check out the links in the description to find where to download it. Please check me out on Twitch. I'm streaming more often now. I keep saying that and then I stop streaming. Follow me on Twitch. That's all you need to know. Also, do me a favor. Look underneath that video real quick. And if that subscribe button is still red, click on it. Make it easier on your eyes. Make it gray, okay? That's better. It matches everything, all right? If you would like to see more tutorials on VTubers, I don't know much, I'm learning also, just let me know in the comment section below. If you watch a VTuber, let me know who that is so I can check them out. And I will see you guys next time. Go out there, make me proud, get a level. Howdy.